Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name's David and this is a Magic Review. Hey, today we're gonna look at Fortuity from David Jonathan and Alakazam. What is Fortuity? Fortuity is a card trick. It's a mentalism trick. It uses a rainbow deck, which is pretty cool. And it's just a really neat way to do a prediction effect with pretty much no skill. It's pretty self-working. You want to see the trailer? This is it.
So I have a deck of cards here. And, well, it's actually a very special deck of cards. Now, I know it looks normal from the front. I mean, it's everything you sort of expect to see in a deck of cards. We have all the different values, all the different suits. Nothing really jumps out as different here. But when you turn it over, you see that it is, in fact, special because each and every card actually comes from a different deck. So you can check these out if you want, but I love playing cards. Each one is kind of like a piece of art to me. All the intricate details and the designs that go into each card, they're all so unique to me. So what I did here is I went through cards that I've hand-picked. I went through all 52 different decks that I own, and I picked out one card from each and sort of assembled this unique, very cool-looking deck of cards here. So, we have a wide variety of selections on the backs, and of course we have all the values in a deck of cards that you'd expect on the fronts, right? So what can we do with a unique deck of cards like this? Well, I'm actually going to have you create your own playing card, but we're going to do this in a very unique way. You see, I don't want you to be influenced. Like, for example, this dragon card might here. That might jump out to you, right? The same way, like, look, if I were to ask you to think of a card right now, odds are you're probably thinking of an ace, a queen, a seven, or a three. They're just common cards that people go to. And the same can be said with these cards right here. I mean, each one is very different, with all these different unique back designs. Some may jump out to you, some might not. But I really don't want to influence you. So instead, we are going to use dice. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll the dice, and whatever number you land on, we're going to count down to the card at that position in the deck. And whatever card that is, we'll use that for the back design. And then we'll do that again for the value. So for example, if we were to roll a 2, we'd count 1, 2, and you'd have this skull card right here. Okay? So give the dice a roll, and we have a 6. Now, would you like the 6 card from the top of the deck, or would you like to have the 6 card from the bottom? It's totally up to you. Top? Sure. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you can confirm that there is no other card in this deck with that same back design, correct? Now here's the interesting thing, you rolled 6, so had you said bottom, it would have been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It would have been a total different card. Remember that. But you said top, and you rolled 6, so we'll go with this card here. Now we'll do the same for a value. So give the dice a roll, and we have an 8. And if you want, you can roll again, but let's say they go for an 8. Now again, would you like the 8th card from the top, or do you want to go for the 8th card from the bottom? Let's say they go for the bottom this time. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The 2 of diamonds. And again, you can confirm there is no other 2 of diamonds in the deck. So had you said top, it would have been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the queen of diamonds. Total different card. But today we ended up on the 2 of diamonds. Now that's interesting. You see, because this envelope has been on the table right here from the very start. And earlier today, I placed one playing card inside. And if you take a look, it's actually a perfect match. Nothing else in the envelope. And that is pretty impressive. All right, I know what you're thinking. Maybe I got lucky, right? I mean, the odds are only 1 in 52. But you also ended up on the 2 of diamonds. See, that's the crazy part. The odds of me getting the back right, that, you know, it could happen. I may have just gotten lucky. But if I were to get the back and the value correct, that double prediction, The odds jump to 1 in over 2,700. I'd say that's a miracle. And sometimes miracles can happen. An absolute perfect match. Could have been any other card. Could have been this way. You chose the two. You chose the design. And that, my friends, is fortuity.
All right, so that was Fortuity, David Jonathan, Alakazam. A couple questions we always ask about all of our Magic reviews, and the first of which is, what's in the box? What's in the box? You're getting a real box and a DVD. It's an hour-long teaching, okay? Hour-long teaching. You're getting the deck, of course. Now, the deck is a rainbow deck, like I mentioned earlier. Rainbow deck means it's comprised up of other decks. So it's 52 decks came together to build this one deck. So every single card is from a different deck. That means every single card will have a different back design. Every single card will have a different type of face, okay? So it's 52 cards, it's a rainbow deck, okay? You're gonna get dice, two little red dice. You're gonna get a prediction envelope, and you're gonna get the forcing card. Is it what I thought? You know what? I really didn't know what to think, actually. I've seen other tricks similar to this, but didn't know how David Jonathan had solved his puzzle, and so I was pleasantly surprised. How are the angles on this? The angles are really clean. There's probably no angles to speak of. I think if you're already familiar with this style of gimmicked deck, and it is a gimmick deck, a classic gimmick deck, if you're already familiar with that and familiar with the handling on it, I think you should have no trouble at all, and your angles should be completely clean. Can it be inspected? No, of course not. It is a gimmicked deck. But you'll show the deck from the front and the back. You know, you'll let the spectator see every card from the face and back. So there shouldn't be any heat on it. And you kind of move through the routine very slowly and allow the spectator to make a free selection on the front and back. And so I think you show the deck fairly, and there shouldn't be a reason why the spectator would want to see it. What's the overall quality and production value of the video? Alakazam makes great videos, okay? It is an hour long, but it is broken up into two sections. So the first section of the video is all Peter Nardi, David Loosely, mostly David Loosely, explaining the effect to you from the Alakazam studio. It's all shot in-house, in-studio. Even the performance is also an in-studio performance. It's not a live performance. And you're basically getting David Loosely explaining everything to you from a seated position at a table. Okay, there's a stationary camera, he's well mic'd. Everything's pretty much that one shot. Then the second part of the video is David Jonathan, okay? And David Jonathan has obviously filmed this himself. So he's filmed it himself, probably in his living room. He's sitting on a couch, he's got a stationary cam. I don't think he's mic'd. It's a little grainy, but it just gives you a second video. It gives you a second teaching. And so you get to hear it from David's mouth. He gets to explain to you where he received his inspiration from. Mostly it was John Bannon's Detour de Force dual match. Those are the ones that he credits. I have Detour de Force from John Bannon, so that was kind of one of the effects that I said earlier that I thought it kind of looked like. There's also another effect that Alakazam released a little earlier called Thoughtwave Extreme. I own that one too, did a review on that one. Similar to that as well, but the solution is different. So the effect is the same, just the solution and the plot is different, but the tricks are similar. So what's taught on the DVD, like I said, it's Peter Nardi, David Loosely, mostly all in studio, going over just the deck, how it's set up, how you can get in and out of the trick. It's basically the routine, and there's just a few pointers. Is it well made? It's very well made. Because these are a lot of decks that you're familiar with already coming together to make this rainbow deck. And like I said, it's a classic gaffed deck. And so there's really no wrong way to make this classically gaffed deck. I don't want to tell you what it is because I don't want to give it away. But yeah, I think it's really well made. You get nice quality dice, good quality production envelope, and you get an hour's worth of teaching. How much practice does this require? Not much. You pretty much just need to memorize the routine, okay? So memorize the routine, how it goes, how you do your selections and how you do the reveal, and then pretty much the deck does all the work for you. It is self-working. How much setup and reset is there? There's almost none. I think at the very beginning, you're putting the prediction card in the envelope, really. And then at the end of the routine, as far as cleanup, there should only be three cards out of place, and you just put those three cards back in the deck and you're good to go. All right, so positives. What are the positives to Fortuity? David Jonathan's Fortuity is a mentalism trick, it's a card trick, it's unexplainable, and it's so, so easy. Negatives. All right, so like we say around here, there's negatives to everything. These are just the negatives that I see. They don't have to be the negatives that you see. Really, everything about this trick is great. Great quality deck, great quality video. Alakazam does great stuff. I love their work. It's a great solution to this plot. For me, it was just too similar to other effects I already do and perform. Okay, I already do the Tour de Force, I already do Thought Wave Extreme. Those are tricks that I already do, they're in my repertoire. And I didn't see anything from Fortuity that I thought could replace those two. So I didn't feel like putting it into my rotation and taking one of those two earlier ones out. So just for me, because I do tricks that are already very similar, then it didn't kind of win a new slot in my repertoire. But if you don't do those style effects, I think this is probably a really good one to pick up. All right, so is it worth your money? It's $38. $38, and like I said, you're getting a gimmick deck. You're getting a gimmick gaff deck comprised up of 52 other decks. So that right there is worth $38, plus the hour long instruction. It's definitely worth your money. All right, so who would like this? I think you could go either way with this. This could be like, you could go a strong card trick with this, or you could go a strong mentalism trick with this. There's certainly some comedy aspects in there. I think it's great for walk arounds. Certainly great for table hopping. I think if you have a table or a surface, or you're doing it in a restaurant or corporate walk around, I think this is great. So it's just a great little pack of trick. Like I said, you stick your deck in there, the envelope, and there are two dice, and you're good to go. You really can't do anything else with this deck. It is a one-hit wonder. So, you know, you will be carrying all of that just for the one effect. But like I said, it's a great effect. All right, so that was Fortuity from David Jonathan and Alakazam. I want to thank Murphy's Magic for allowing me to have this trick so that I could do the review for you. And if you'd like to purchase this trick for yourself, you can find it from your very favorite Murphy's Magic dealer. Thanks, bye.